All right, let's go back to Craig Herrera for a look at weather. And my son and I did a little transplanting, got some pumpkin plants in and flowers today, Craig. We had some showers, so perfect timing for our showers today.
That's awesome. Now they're going to get some water and they're just going to flourish, right? How awesome. I can't wait to see what comes of that. That's awesome. We put some grass in the backyard, Mark, so it's the seed has come up. It came up about 2 weeks ago, so this is going to help out as well. And we get some sunbreaks in the mix, and that's also helping. So we've got a nice little system going here for the next several days, although we do have some thunderstorms in the mix as well today and possibly tomorrow. Hey, take a look at this time lapse from Auburn High School, Auburn, the mountain. Normally you would be able to see it, but we've got some mid-level clouds as well as some of those high clouds. Highs today, we actually made it to 63 at SeaTac, got to 60 in Arlington. Bellingham, you got to 64. Chehalis, 63. Hoquiam, 58. And now it's actually cooled a little bit. If you step outside, I just stepped outside to bring the dogs in, you can feel a little bit of a chill. We're down to the 50s. Got a little bit of a breeze coming through. Not strong, but enough to give us some cooler air. We've got mostly out of the west-southwest at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Not real strong. A lot of it is wrapping around this system, and I'll get back to the radar and show you what we have. Notice that little cell just to the east of Bellingham. That's actually just a return on the radar, so that looks a little more intense than it is. That's just the way that's returning on the radar for this specific site here. But we do have some cells that are producing some heavy rain. At times, I've seen a couple of lightning strikes, so we could get some hail or some brief heavy downpours. Now that we're losing the daytime heating, we're starting to lose some of that energy, but we could still get some of those heavy downpours. Tonight, Chehalis says that system I showed you just a moment ago continues to move off to the north and northeast. Now notice the rain over the Olympic Mountains and over the Olympic Peninsula starting to swing around and head into a new direction rather than going to the north and northeast. Here it's going up to the north and northwest. It's circling around this area of low pressure just off the coast, and that's why we're seeing that wind direction shift there. Pause a moment with Craig. Tomorrow, take a look at Sosa and Sabo. So, scattered showers at 9 a.m. We will get some sun breaks between 10 and about 2, but then we have more scattered showers in the forecast at 3. Here's timing, 9:30, a few scattered showers. 12, you got some breaks. 8 o'clock Sunday, there we go, tomorrow, a few breaks, and then we've got some scattered showers by the time we get into the afternoon and into the evening hours. Rainfall totals with this at about a quarter of an inch of rain at best. Snowfall levels, by the way, in the mountains will drop to 4,500 feet. And along the passes, temperatures will be in the 40s. We could get some snow close to the passes tomorrow afternoon. However, it really won't stick because the temperature on the road is going to be right about 40 degrees or so. But Mark, we've got this pattern going through for the next several days where you got the sunshine to help the things grow, some water to help them flourish as well, and then a little bit of break here and there right through the next 7 days.
All right. Sounds good, Craig. Thank you for that.